It went down in history as Australia's Black Summer, a 19-week period in late 2019 and early 2020 when 24 million hectares of the country burned. That's an area half the size of California or the entire United Kingdom. The smoke circled the globe. Now the stage is set for a possible repeat. This map from the National Council for Fire and Emergency Services showing large areas of Australia facing increased fire risk. Bloomberg Economics is forecasting property and casualty insurance costs in Australia to the year ending June 2024 could be well above the 10-year average of $3 billion.
So this fire season, we've seen a significant drying out of the landscape following 3 years of above average rainfall. That's particularly that above average rainfall has promoted grass growth and obviously increase in fuel. And then we've started to see really dry winter then into spring. So we're seeing an elevated risk.
To help combat that risk, the fire service has commissioned Athena, a world-first firefighting AI. Athena analyzes data from weather forecasts, wind direction, terrain structures, populated areas, and even social media feeds to predict the fire's next move and what's at risk.
It takes a map of those fires and it then predicts what they'll do over 2 hours, 4 hours, 12 hours, and it will also tell us what structures or assets will come into threat. We can have more than 100 fires burning at any one time, and this stops us potentially making any mistakes or missing something.
Athena's modelling is also supported by data provided by the Pyrotron, a bushfire simulator built after Black Summer by government research body, the CSIRO. The fire service has also added Australia's largest firefighting helicopter for the coming summer, hoping history doesn't repeat, but ready in case it does. Paul Allen, Bloomberg, Sydney.